Hey guys, in this episode, I'm going to talk about routing in Blazor WebAssembly applications. So first, I'll talk about the basics, like how you can navigate from one page to another using C# function. And then I'm going to talk about how you can do it in traditional way using href, and how you can pass parameters, you know, let it be string or integer or any other data type. Using your hyperlink, okay? And then I'm gonna dive a little deeper into routing and try to add a third-party assembly into my router, which is in app.tracer. And here I'm gonna tell my router that there is an additional assembly that I would like to add in the router so that it can use the third-party pages in my application. Okay, so let's first talk about the use case here. If you look at our Blazing chat application, I have this contacts list, and when I click on this contact list, it uses some routing to go navigate from one component to another component. And you can see that, you know, it passes a parameter and it goes to a chat component. Okay, so that's what I would like to do in my Blazing application, which is very boring. Here I have weather forecast and I'm listing down some random weather forecast, but instead of that I would like to list down the contacts, and then whenever I click on those contacts, I want it to go to a chat component. With some parameters. Okay, so for that, I have given myself a head start. In my shared project, I've added a contact class, which has contact ID, first name, last name, and there's a constructor which takes three parameters and assigns those properties. Okay, and if you go to my client page, which is contacts page, on initialize, just like we are pulling some forecast, I have created a property for contact list, which is list of contacts, and then I'm adding some contacts in that contact list. So this is, I just created a class and demo data so that we can use that for our demo. Okay, so like I said, instead of showing this weather forecast, I would like to show my contacts. So for that, what I'm going to do, I'm going to stop the server, and then I'm going to add my own HTML. I don't want that weather forecast HTML. And here I'm going to add a div, and see that this is column 12. And here I would like to loop through my contact list. So for that, I'm going to use for each loop here, which is in the collection of contact list, I would like to take care of each contact here, and then create some dynamic links. So for that, I'm gonna add a link here, and see that this is going to show the first name and the last name of the contact. So for that, I'm gonna say contact first name, and let's add some span in between so that it looks a little nicer. And then I'm gonna say it's contact dot last name. Okay, and I'm gonna add some little bit of class here so that it looks a little nicer. For that, I'm gonna copy some CSS, copy that and paste it here. Sweet. So let's run this and see how this looks first, and then we will add some C# function to call to navigate it from the contacts page to the chat window. Let's run this and see how this is going to look like first. So I'm on weather forecast here. Once this is done running, I'll refresh my page, and now you can see that it shows Julius Caesar, Daniel Cinoni, Gary Thomas, and all the people in the contact list here. Okay, so instead of like I said, when I click on this, I want it to go to the chat component that we'll have to create, right? So for that, I'm gonna stop the server, and then I'm gonna go to my chat page. Say that this is a Razor page, so that this is chat.razor, and here I'm gonna tell I'm going to tell my razor page this razor component has an address, and that address is going to be checked. Okay, and I'm going to add some HTML here. So I'm going to say the header tag, this is chat page, and I'm gonna go back to my contacts page, and here I want to tell my hyperlink that whenever I click on it, I want it to go to this razor component, right? So first I'll try to do that using C# function, and then I will try to do it user hyperlink. So let's first create that C# function. So I'm gonna create a function called its private navigate to chat, and this doesn't return anything, it doesn't take anything, and I want to map this function to my hyperlink. So for that, I'm gonna say on click of this hyperlink, I want to call the C# function, which is going to be navigate to chat. Okay. So whenever I click on it, this is going to call the C# function, but I need to tell my C# function to navigate to that chat window, right? So for that, I'm going to inject a dependency. I'm going to inject a dependency for this navigation manager. Navigation manager is pretty cool. It has a lot of functions that you can use for manipulating URLs. So I'm going to use this dependency and say that navigation manager dot navigate to, I want to go to the chat component. Okay. So this will, whenever I click on this hyperlink, it will call this navigate to chat function, and it will use navigation manager that we injected to navigate to chat. Okay. The component that we just created. Okay. Sweet. Let's run this and see if this is going to work or not. So I'm going to run that and go to my browser and refresh my page. And when I click on this, you can see that whenever I click on it, it goes to that route, the chat route, and says that this is a chat page. So when I click on Gary Thomas, everywhere I click on it, it takes me to that page. Okay. So that's how you can use Navigation Manager. And like I said, Navigation Manager is pretty cool. You can go to this documentation for routing, and I'll share this link in the video description. But if you could go to Navigation Manager, you can see that it has some functions which you can call, like navigate to, base URI. There are some properties, some functions that you can call to manipulate your URLs. Okay. So we use Navigation Manager now, but I would like to do it in traditional way. Like, instead of calling this onClick function, I want to say that I want to call href, and then I want to go to the chat window. Okay, so you can do it this way too. Let's run this and see if that is going to work or not. I'm going to go to my contacts page. This is done running. I'm going to refresh the page, and when I click on it, you can see that it takes me to the chat page, and you can see that it gives you like this nice mouse, like hand mouse icon, whatever that is called. But that's because I'm using this href, and it can take you to the page. Okay, so that's how you can use href. How do we pass parameters? So by default, Razor components takes string as parameters. And if you want to pass string as parameters, what you have to do, you have to go to your component and say that this takes, let's say it takes first name of the contact as parameter. And once you mention that, then you'll have to write some C# code to define that as a parameter. So for that, I'm going to create a property. I'm going to say public string same name, first name, and I'm going to get and set this property. And then I'm going to say that I'm going to add a attribute called as parameter, so that we know that this is a parameter. And then I'm going to add some HTML here to say that, show that we can use this parameter on our HTML page too. So I'm going to say that this is @first name, and that will get shown on our HTML. Whatever we are passing will get shown on the HTML. And in the contacts page here, I want to pass that as a parameter. So I'm going to say @ because I want to try to access a C# variable contact, and I'm going to say first name. So what this is going to do, whenever I click on it, it will go to the chat window and it will take the first name of the contact that I'm looping through, and it will pass to the chat window and show that first name. It will cache that first name into the string property, and it will show it on the HTML. So let's run this and see if this is going to work or not. So I'll go to my contacts page and then refresh this page and then click on it. You can see that this page is of Julius. And if I go to Daniel, you can see that it's passing that parameter in the URL, and then it's catching on this property and showing it on HTML. Awesome, right? Okay, so that's how you can pass parameters. Before I jump into passing integers, one thing that I want to show is, let's first run this and show an error. If I remove this parameter and hit enter, it's gonna show an error saying that, sorry, there is nothing at this address. That means that you have to pass, if you define a parameter, you have to pass that parameter in the URL every time. So if you don't want to dodge that problem, the way you can do that is by having multiple routes. So you can say that, okay, that route is fine, but sometimes there might not be a parameter. So for handling that scenario, I can just say, you know, chat, and then that should fix the problem. So if I go run this again and refreshing my page should fix it. And you can see that there's that chat component, and then it's not really showing any parameter, because it's not really showing any string, because, you know, we're not passing any string, but it does handle that situation too. Okay, so now we can pass parameter. Let's try to pass an integer. For, like I said, in Razor components take a string by default as parameters, but if you want to pass an integer, you have to mention that the type of your parameter. So here you can pass mention that, like colon integer, but first name sounds silly, so I'm gonna say this is going to be contact ID. And I'm gonna, instead of showing contact first name, I'm gonna say this is going to be contact ID. This is going to be contact ID. It is going to be an integer. And instead of passing first name, I would like to pass contact ID now. Okay, sweet. Let's run this and see if this is going to run or not. So if I go to my browser, go back to my contacts page and refresh my page, and then click on Julius, you can see that now it is passing the contact ID as an integer. So if I click on Daniel, it is contact ID is 2 and then 4, likewise. Okay, so that's how you can, you know, pass parameters. You can have different data types. So if you want to find out different data types, you can go to the same documentation, and then there's a list of data types that you can pass, and you can try that out too. Okay, so that's all about the basics. Let's dive deeper into this now. Okay, so let's assume that I don't want to write this chat page. I don't want to write this chat page. My friend wrote it, or I found a NuGet package online, which is a Razor class library, and I want to use that component in my chat page. Okay, so for showing that demo, what I've done, I've added this third-party chat library, which has this third-party chat component, which is much better than what I have right now. It shows, it has some cool CSS files and, you know, some cool C# code. And I would like to use this third-party chat component instead of using my boring chat component, okay? For that, the one way I can use that third-party chat component is just by adding reference. So I can add the third-party project reference into my client project, and then go to imports.razor and add the namespace into my imports.razor file. And then in the chat component, instead of showing this HTML, what I could do, I could just say, I want to just use third party. I want to use third party. Third-party chat component. I think that should work. Third-party chat component. And yeah, that should work. And I'm gonna stop the server and rerun that and go back to my web page here and go to contacts. And when I click on Julius Caesar, let's refresh the page first. If I go to contacts and go to Julius Caesar, you can see that now I'm using the chat component that my friend wrote or the NuGet package that I added. But adding that chat component as third-party chat component into your chat component is kind of silly, right? Instead of that, what I would like to do is this chat third-party chat component already has routes, right? And I don't want to use my chat component. I don't want to have like another chat component add another component into it. For that, what I'm going to do, I am going to delete this component. I'm going to delete that component. And then I want to tell my app.razor that, hey, Razor, you added an assembly. You told your router that, you know, use all the routes from assembly of program.cs file, which is this file. But I would like to add some additional assemblies too. And here I would like, I'm gonna mention the third party component here because I want to use all the routes from my third party component, third party library that my friend wrote, or it's a NuGet package. So I'm gonna say that this is going to be type of third party component, third party chat razor and dot assembly. Okay, so that's how my router knows that, okay, we have to take all the routes, consider all the routes from this program.cs, and then we'll have to also consider all the routes from the third party chat component library assembly so that we can cater those requests too. So now you can see that I don't have my chat component anymore. We deleted that, and I'm going to use this third party chat component for for navigating from my contacts page to my chat component page. So I'm gonna run this and go back to my browser and go to my chat page and refresh this. And we do not have chat component. We are going to use the chat component of chat component, which is third party chat component. And when I click on it, you can see that it still works. So if I click on different pages, you can see that it still works. So I did not have to write any component. I'm using third party component. I just had to add an additional assembly into my app.razor, and I could use the routes of third party components. That's pretty awesome, right? And that's what I love Blazor, because it makes you build Razor components, Razor component libraries, class libraries, which you can share with your friends, you can share on internet so that people can reuse code instead of rewriting their code, okay? So that's all about routing. If you guys have any questions, you can reach out to me on Twitter or Facebook, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Thanks for watching, bye.